going on, guys, and welcome back to Pete's Carport. Today we're going to be working on the SC300 drip build. This is episode 2. If you didn't catch episode 1 where we gutted the inside, go ahead and I'm going to link that down below. Check it out. You can also see the video where we picked up the car, and it is a manual with the R154 transmission. I was dying to find one of these cars and came across it. So now we're going to turn it into a drift car. And I'm very excited about this because it's technically the first car that I'm going to be able to gut, build, and track. So we're going to be doing everything from throwing a roll cage in there, starting with a harness bar. We're going to be putting in racing seats, racing harnesses, the steering wheel. And speaking of the steering wheel, I got that over here. So each one of these series is going to have, or episodes is going to have, a different part to the car. So the steering wheel is probably going to be on the next episode, which will be 3. And if you guys are interested on how to install one of these quick release steering wheels, that'll be coming up next. But back to what we're doing today. So the first video, me and Xavier stripped out all the interior, including the seat belts, etc. And we're prepping it so that we can put in LRB Speed aluminum panels. We also started to play around with the trunk. On this episode, I'm going to take everything out of the trunk, and I think we're going to do the exact same thing that we're doing with the inside, and LRB does sell an aluminum drop-in for that. So let's go ahead and get started. We can start pulling everything out. Once I get everything out, we're going to basically try to strip off any of the glue and gunk that might be on the floor, and then we're going to wipe it down, wax and tar remover. I'm not too concerned with sanding it because a lot of it I am going to be trying to put aluminum panels in and maybe even some soundproofing because I don't want it to be extremely loud in there, but I still want to have it gutted. And then we're going to be removing it and then coating it with our rubberized coating. So let's get started, guys. Alright guys, I figured I'd fill you in now to kind of give you the vision I have for this, what I'm trying to do, because I didn't want to make this a super boring video of just painting. I wanted to show you the progress that I've gotten. So I went ahead and pulled out this entire center console. A lot of that is because I really want to clean it down. It's absolutely disgusting. And putting down this rubber coating, I'll be able to get up under here. And the concept of everything that I'm doing really is to deaden a lot of the sound, because there's no carpet. So everything that is still in here is going to be shaking and rocking on the frame of the car. And I'm not sure if I'm going to put any type of soundproofing down yet. That's still kind of up in the air. But I figured it couldn't hurt to basically spray all back here with all the rubberized stuff. Get, you know, all these inside panels so that they have some sort of sound dampening in the car. Something that's not going to be heavy. Obviously, painting it on there is not going to add nearly as much as adding a full carpet kit. So basically what my goal here is, I took out the center console, I'm going to clean that sucker down. We're going to be putting in the LRB center piece here anyway, so I kind of wanted to configure that, because there's a lot of options online. If you go to their website, you'll know what I'm talking about. And I wanted to pull those out just to kind of get them out of the way so I can get up underneath them. And the other thing is I want it all to be black, because I'm going to be doing the door panels, the door jams, underneath everything over there in a gloss black, and I don't want to open the door and go from gloss black to this green. Even though it is just a drift car, I want it to look really nice because I have the time to do all this stuff, and it's not costly. It's stuff that's just going to make the overall design of this drift car look nicer, because I do want to bring it to car shows as I'm building it to kind of fill people in. So that's just a quick fill-in, guys. I'm going to get back to work. I'm going to pull that about away. I did go ahead and pull out the AC vent here, and my plan is to cap off that area so I get a little more air in the vent here. I am not deleting the AC. If you live in Florida or you've ever been here, you will see why. There are tons of mosquitoes in the car right now, and it is absolutely humid. I can't even explain. I'm dripping with sweat right now just from 10 minutes of doing this. And I do not want to plan to do any type of driving and drifting in the summer or even spring in this car without AC. The last thing I wanted to mention is we've got a new steering wheel, seats, seat brackets, all that stuff on the way. I may be putting a roll cage in, but I have to put something in order to mount the harnesses too. So I'll be working on that over the next couple of days and fill you guys in. But let's get back to work so I can show you guys the progress of the rubberized painting of the inside. All right, guys, now that we've got everything on the inside pulled out, I'm gonna go ahead and we're going to pull everything out of this trunk, all the lining, all the crap that's unnecessary. The goal here is limited weight, obviously, but you know, obviously some of these liners don't weigh much, but I like to get rid of everything and just kind of have like a clean build, all rubberized coating inside here on the inside of the car, and basically giving me ample room to add things to this trunk if necessary in the future, performance things, et cetera, et cetera. So let's go ahead. I'm gonna pull everything out of this trunk, and then we'll get started on cleaning this down, painting both of those sections. Alright guys, so one of the fun things about getting a new car is sometimes you open up places like trunks and glove boxes and you come across valuable things or parts and stuff that you thought were missing from the car that somebody just stuck somewhere else. So I found some really neat things. There's actually the stock floor mat in here that says Lexus on it. I kind of tossed everything into a pile. It's got all the lining, which is great because if I'm missing any parts on my other car, I can definitely use that Lexus floor mat. There's a headlight over there, which I'm not sure why, but it looks like it's in pretty good shape. Your CD DVD changer, that'll probably just be tossed out. But I don't know if you guys saw, but I showed you the stock glass lights that are in perfect shape. Not sure why those are in the trunk, but the ones on the car are plastic and completely destroyed. So I'm guessing that front bumper was pulled and somebody converted it over to plastic ones. And then the kicker. So like I told you guys, I had no clue what kind of suspension was on here. I had tried to guess that the coilovers were the same ones on my car. This says coilover conversion kit on the box, and it looks like a China brand. I'm gonna look it up when I get a second, but it's I don't want to show the guy's address, but it is a cheaper looking set. If you guys know what this is, fill me in. But there's still some suspension components that are not on the car, obviously. So I hope when I get this up in the air, I'll be able to figure out exactly where those parts may go if they just didn't put them on, or if it wasn't something necessary for this vehicle, because sometimes people throw stuff in the trunk that are for other cars. Now, I want your opinion on this part. The reason why I'm trying to do a lot of what I'm doing is, so if you're racing, drifting, etc., you want to be able to access everything really easily, obviously taking any weight out you can, any unnecessary components. But I'm thinking about covering up the gas tank with the covers or even relining this trunk, since you're talking about extremely minimal weight. But I did want to get all this out because I do want to spray it all down with the black. My goal here is to eliminate any of the green, and I'm probably just going to coat that gas tank with the rubberized spray because it's not going to hurt it. It's not something that gets hot. But the nice thing about having all this out is you can easily access your coilovers. If you need to change those, you can access your gas tank, and you don't have to go ripping anything out. And really, no one's ever going to look in this trunk except for me, because it's not going to be a daily used car. So let me know what you guys think. Most people that drift pull everything out, including the AC. I am not doing that because, like I said earlier, I'm in Florida and I am not dealing with no AC. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this off. We're going to clean everything down, and then I'll show you guys what we're going to be doing with the rubberized spray and getting everything set up and prepped. All right, guys, so it started to rain pretty heavily, so I'm sorry about the sound. I'm underneath the carport, so you're going to hear that rain beating off of it. But I wanted to show you guys the next stage that I'm going to be doing so you understand how I did this. I basically am going to take one of these brushes and just scrub any of the gunk that might still be within here. I'm going to vacuum it all out. I grab my wax and tar remover, and I'm just going to scrub down once more with that, wipe everything really clean, and I'm going to spray everything down. Like I said, I'm not overly concerned if it does chip up a little bit. I may run some sandpaper along the edge here since that's where I'll be getting in and out, and I don't want that to chip off. But back here, it's really just for soundproofing, so I'm not even going to really worry about that. I'm just going to spray it down. That's going to be covered by the aluminum paneling from LRB. So just wanted to fill you in case you saw it and you were wondering why I didn't sand everything down. It's really just a protection against sound, and almost all of the paneling is going to have some sort of cover over it by the end of this project. So let's get started. I'm going to speed through all this, and you guys will kind of see as I'm doing it. Alright guys, so it's all finished up. I actually used two whole cans, and I probably needed more. Now, I'm going to say this right now, I am not really happy with it at all, but it was a complete test. I wanted to try to see what I could do to eliminate some of the rattle noise while I'm driving around just normal streets, because I'm not putting any carpeting back in. But I'm also debating between putting some sort of insulation and possibly aluminum paneling. So now I am really veering towards that. I did not mention this earlier, but I did a test strip yesterday across there, and when I came in, I started to wipe that down with the wax and tar remover, and it came right off. So my thought is some of this isn't going to stick, but I decided to spray it all down anyways. And if any of you guys are thinking about doing this, it doesn't seem like a really pliable substance. It doesn't seem like it sticks really well, which really upsets me, because you'd think that being Rust-Oleum, it would spray on like any of their other paint and kind of give it like a really heavy coating. I mean, they're recommending this on underbellies of cars, and I've seen people use it before. And then the trunk, I'm going to put that up on the screen now. I realize that LRB makes an aluminum tray that kind of covers up the area where the tire goes. And I have all the nice paneling still, so I may revert to what it looks like exactly in this photo. And then, like I said, what I think I'm going to do is either get with LRB or make myself an aluminum panel for there, and an aluminum panel that'll go back here and back there for both sides, obviously. And even thought about doing a 90-degree bent thin aluminum panel along here, just to keep myself from scratching that up, getting in and out, and then you're going to see that nasty green color. Of course, we're going to be really prepping and sanding down all the door paneling here and coating that with the Rust-Oleum Turbo Spray, which is a high gloss, and then doing a 2K clear. And we're going to be doing that on the inside and outside of the car. The goal is to convert this to a black base car, so I can take it from there and either do some fun plastidip projects with it, or even keep it black and maybe down the road do some custom paint on it or whatever I decide. So that's kind of the route I'm going for this drift car, is to get the whole thing black. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I know this was more of a boring part of this. Next episode is going to be the steering wheel, which I know a lot more of you guys are probably excited to see. But I want to show you guys the entire progress on this project, how I'm doing this, the thought process behind it, what works, what doesn't work, and also for your guys' input. So let me know what you want to see, any suggestions you guys have, and have an awesome day, awesome week. This project's going to go a little faster than I may have originally thought just to get it on the street, but it's still going to be probably a year or so out before I ever see a track, because I want this to be completely safe, completely done right, and I've got a lot of ideas that I'm going to be doing, some things I've already ordered in that won't be for track but will allow me to test it out on the street. Have a great day, guys. Like, subscribe, and share if you want to see more of this SC300 drift project.